In this video, I'm going to explain why fast rib is important. This is fast rib. It is not very big structure. It looks like it's not that important. However, it is so important. So let me show you the related structure with fast rib. Okay, this is right side of body. This is fast rib. And imagine clavicle is removed. Okay, there should be clavicle. Let's look at these muscles. These are scalene. This part is anterior scalene. This part is middle scalene. Anterior and middle scalene. These two muscles attach on fast rib. Why are they so important? Because you see yellow bundles kind of pass between anterior scalene and middle scalene. What are they? They are brachial plexus. Brachial plexus is bundle of nerve, and it sends nerves to chest area, shoulder area, arm, forearm, wrist, fingers. Basically, it sends nerves to all over the upper limb. Okay? And brachial plexus passes between scalene. What happens when scalene gets tight? That creates impingement for brachial plexus. What happens it got impingement here? That can affect brachial plexus for rest of the upper limb. Okay, and why is that so important with fast rib? This place is very, very busy place, right? Because scalene is here. Brachial plexus is here. One of the functions of scalene is inhalation, because that attaches on fast rib. It can pull up fast rib. If fast rib is elevated, that can create friction with brachial plexus, right? So, plus if scalene gets tight, that can fix fast rib at elevated position, plus that can create impingement here. Then there's more risk for brachial plexus got impingement, correct? That's why scalene, brachial plexus, and fast rib are very, very important. If there's pain here, it is thoracic outlet syndrome. Thoracic outlet syndrome. This can be one reason for thoracic outlet syndrome. Scalene, brachial plexus, and fast rib. Now let me talk about relationship with other tissues. Brachial plexus is not only tissue that has relationship with fast rib. What is other tissue? That is this one. This is subclavian artery. Subclavian artery. This artery is very, very important. That sends branch to neck, that sends branch to internal chest, that sends branch to shoulder, arm, wrist, fingers. This is very important for head, neck, and upper limb. Subclavian artery also passes between anterior scalene and middle scalene, and it, you know, it has attachment with fast rib, this area. Again, what happens if scalene gets tight? That elevates fast rib, and it diminishes space between anterior scalene and middle scalene. What happens to circulation? That can decrease, correct? So brachial plexus and subclavian artery have relationship with first rib. And also this vein, this is subclavian vein. This has also important relationship with first rib. Big nerves, big artery, big vein have relationship with first rib. Now that sounds very important, correct? There is one more very important connection. That is inside of chest. You know, there's lung inside, there's heart inside of ribcage, correct? These are covered by membrane, that is pleura. Pleura. Pleura is membrane inside ribcage. There is topmost part right here. There is connection between top of pleura and other tissues. Especially most important thing is anterior scaling. Anterior scaling has fascial connection to inside of ribcage. Again, what happens if anterior scaling gets tight? That can create tension for pleura. That can affect whole inside of ribcage, right? That's why first rib relationship with scaling, brachial plexus, subclavian artery, subclavian vein, and pleura are very, very important. As I said, this place is very tiny. However, it is very, very busy place. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.